let's talk about the Financial Action Task Force, Senator. A lot of things we need to discuss with you. Just to give a brief background, and please correct me if I'm wrong, sir. We're on the gray list area right now. We almost was downgraded from dark gray to gray again because we failed to pass the third measure that the FATF was asking us to pass, the Philippines. Correct, sir?
We were downgraded from gray to dark gray earlier this year, about January, because we did not pass the two measures. But we did in May. So what was hanging was the third measure. But because we did in May, they gave us an upgrade from dark gray to gray.
Right, yeah.
When we did not pass
the third one,
there was a threat that we would be downgraded to blacklist already. However, our team was able to convince the Financial Action Task Force, I think they met in Paris, that we had just run out of time.
Okay.
And so to give us 3 or 4 months leeway, and that by the end of January we should have passed the law.
So I guess that's the time frame they're looking at. Contentious issues, sir. How I understand it is that you need to add 9 predicate crimes and 20 plus activities.
23
to the Anti-Money Laundering Act. The most contentious would be in the predicate crimes would be tax evasion, right?
That's always been the most contentious. When I filed one of my bills in 2001, tax evasion was there, pinatanggal. 2003, pinatanggal. So that's always going to be removed. I expect it will be removed.
Even when you continue hearings on this, you feel that matatanggal ng tax evasion?
Yes, because the recommendations of the Financial Action Task Force, the 9 covered institutions and the 23 predicate crimes are recommendations.
Okay.
All right. However, it's almost like automatic if we do not subscribe to it, because the Financial Action Task Force is the group. It's a group of 31 nations. We are a member only by virtue of our being part of the Asia-Pacific group. And while they cannot impose sanctions, all they can do is, it's like a rating, like the Standard and Poor or the Fitch ratings, when they say failing grade yan.
Right.
Then we start getting restrictions imposed by other jurisdictions. So for example, I'll give you an example. When the United States started pressuring the Swiss government and the Swiss Central Bank to deliver the list of Americans who were salting their dollars in away in Switzerland in order to avoid U.S. taxes, Switzerland said, no, we're not going to cooperate. We're a separate country. And then the Americans said, that's fine. And the American banks, with whom the Swiss banks do a great deal amount of business, said, all right, we're not going to be too cooperative.
Uh-huh.
And the Swiss just collapsed. The Swiss collapsed, that their branches, the branches of the Swiss banks in America were fined $780 million, and they paid.
Yeah, so there are repercussions.
Malalaki sila. So, we have to do business with the U.S., with Japan, with Europe, etc. So if they say, teka muna pinky, don't send any money, we cannot transmit any money this month to your relatives because...
binabantayan kami ngayon eh.
My gosh, that's really going to hurt our economy.
So what would be the outcome, Senator, if they wanted an additional 9 predicate crimes? And for example, as you were saying, tax evasion might not make it. Would that be a problem for the FATF?
I think we can argue our way and play for time out of that one, because one aspect is they describe the crime as a violation of the Internal Revenue Code, mm-hmm, of a specific country. And tax evasion is only one violation.
That's
so
true, yeah.
So we can include a phrase that says, violation of the Internal Revenue Code except section XXX.
So you're just disguising it, really?
Well, you know, these are games people play.
Okay.
I mean, I'm not in favor of it. I've been pushing the thing since 2001, but wala tayong magagawa. So we're going to try to come as close to what the FAT recommends, the FATF recommends.
But you do understand, or do you accept the reasoning of some of your colleagues that this can be used for political persecution?
Yes, yes, yes. There is always that fear and that danger. You're right.
Okay.
So come election time, they can use that against you. I mean, if they're in power, then
yes,
they're sitting in Malacanang at medyo galit kay Pinky Web.
They will
raise that.
Okay.
Even if it's not true, tapos
yes
na yung campaign. Tinamaan ka na.
Oh. Yeah. Okay. So you're a little bit open to that. Let's talk. This one, I think you're quite sure of or certain, or you really want this in. The real estate properties that are bought. My understanding, sir, is that if you buy a real estate property and make a down payment of $10,000, roughly 400,000 pesos, more
yeah
or less.
410,000 now.
410,000. You want that included in the list of activities,
that's
included
right
in the 23 list of activities.
Uh-huh.
Senate President Juan Ponce Enrilet doesn't want this done. He argues, sir, anyway, you can go to the BIR and check the income of Pinky and see if I can actually afford to buy this piece of property. So why include it in the activities?
That's begging the question. The reason why, like banks, for example, for the last 40, 50 years in the United States, the $10,000 reporting limit was already in place, no?
That's
so
true.
So I went to a bank, say if I went to the Wells Fargo branch
yeah,
in California, and I had cash deposit of $11,000, they would report that. I did not violate the law. They just report it at iniipon yung
data.
Wow, I mean, they had huge computers. They do have huge computer system. And later, the computer will be able to figure out if there's a pattern that Sergio deposits large amounts without having any financial justification for it. Wala naman silang income, wala naman siyang... So they will just invite me and say, may we know where this money is coming from? Because I will not have violated any law at that point. So these are just warning signals that the financial community
yeah
wants in order to be sure that they would be able to cover the loopholes that now exist in the anti-money laundering law.
So
that's a very big loophole, by the way.
So I understand, sir, tax evasion, but properties, I'm kind of open to it because I don't understand why not.
Okay, let me explain to you. I have X amount. Let's say I make 10 million pesos a month in drug dealing. All right. Gusto ko tanguin yan, no? I mean, I can't go around and buy a big mansion and live in it because people say, teka muna, where did you get that?
Pera
yeah
niyan.
Okay.
Mm.
So I'm going to try to launder it so it comes back to me legally. So I can ask a friend to sell me his company for 10 million pesos when actually the company is only worth 2 million, right?
Pero yeah,
na-launder ko na.
Correct.
So
yeah,
now after 1 year, legal na yon, then I will now sell it
yeah
and I take my cash out. Real estate is one of the biggest ways to launder money. Because I have 10 million, so I'll go to Cagayan de Oro
mm-hmm
and I'll buy a piece of real estate. Never mind the $10,000, that's nothing.
Mm.
I mean, you know, we're looking for the 10, 20 million transactions and taking and seeing how they match a whole, no? So in Cagayan de Oro, I'll buy 10 million, and then next month in Zamboanga, I'll buy another 10 million. You need good computers to keep track of this, but you do want that reported. And maybe it will take 2, 3, 4, 5 years, but a pattern will come
Tagal
up.
Din, no, sir?
Yes.
2, 3, 4, 5 years.
It's not an overnight thing.
No, actually, what I was telling you, sir, was that I understood the problem of tax evasion being part of a predicate crime. I understand that completely. What I don't understand is the opposition to real estate being part of the activities that could be observed under, because obviously, sir, I mean, una-una, it's got to be in your, you know, somehow your statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth if you're a government official.
Only if you're a government official, but we're not trying to catch government officials per se. We're trying to catch money launderers.
Sir, that's what I'm saying. SAL, SAL N for government officials. See, this does not include you guys being government officials. That's why I was saying I don't get why there is some opposition to buying real estate property being listed as part of the activities for AMLA.
Oh, I see. You don't know why politicians are objecting to it because
yes,
they already have.
That's what I'm asking you.
Why don't you ask them?
because I don't know. I'm trying to understand why, but I don't seem to get it. But you think that will still be a problem? You think that will also be removed?
I hope. I hope to be able to explain it to them. We'll get some information or more information from the Financial Action Task Force. Mm-hmm. You know, the FATF says, here's the whole caboodle. Kayo, may butas dito, 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 dito. Pwede ba?
Tapalan nyo na yung butas.
Oh.
Well, that also includes, sir, casinos.
That's right.
Earnings from casinos. Because that you can also pretend to have some winnings in casinos, right? And use that as...
Very easily. I will go to the casino and I'll give them... say ₱1,000,000. Okay, give me ₱1,000,000 worth of chips, and I'll leave the casino with ₱10,000,000 worth of chips. Legal na yun.
Mm-mm, mm-mm. Winnings mo yun sa casino.
Yeah, I will declare it as winnings.
Exactly. Okay, so that's another one that needs to be looked at. Yeah. And you also said, sir, people engaged in gold, silver, precious.
Yes,
metals.
Also, yeah, jewelry.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean. See, there's a lot of subjectivity, so I can always say, I bought this diamond from Pinky for $1,000,000, but some fool bought it from me for $10,000,000. Anong kagawa ko?
Diba? Naswertehan ako doon. Hanap ka lang ng ibang tao that will say, yes, I bought it for $10,000,000. All right, but you are confident, Senator, that by January, this will make it?
And I'm not that confident. In other words, I'd give it a confidence factor of about 75%.
Okay.
That's just a lot. That's 9 plus 23. So, you know, we're going to see what the body is willing to approve.